Next up, I want to talk about Google File Stream. And this is really where the magic comes in how Google allow you to use Google Drive like a business server for all the files in your business. Now, I've been saying throughout our presentation that you should put all of your files and all of your data up in Google Cloud. Each user in Google Workspace now has access to at least 2 terabytes of storage per person. Trust me, that's plenty. I have years of 4K drone footage and 4K studio raw recordings, and I'm only hitting about 3 or 4 terabytes myself personally. But for each staff member you have in the business, you have another 2 terabytes, and they're all pulled together in one shared pool of storage. So unless you're absolutely nuts, and I've not in 2,000 odd businesses that I've worked with over 12 years, I've not seen a business who's had more than about 10 or 20 terabytes of data. And if they do, usually they've got a lot of staff, so they've got enough storage there. So here's one of the magic things that you can actually do with Google File Stream. Now, the old way of storing files and storing storage, you would know with Dropbox, is that if you have 100 gigabytes of files, it's gonna take up 100 gigabytes of storage on your computer. That's just the way that Dropbox works. It's synchronizing the files back and forward. And so Dropbox has this feature called Selective Sync, and you can basically, you know, play the tick box game and tick and untick different folders. But then some files are only gonna exist online on the web, and only some files are gonna exist down on your local computer when you want to access them. Well, what Google File Stream does is it's a cloud connector between you and the cloud. And what that does is, even if you have 100 gigabytes of files stored inside of Google Drive online, it's only going to synchronize what you're using or what you choose to have available locally on your computer. And it's gonna intelligently move those files back and forward between the web, online, and your local machine. But importantly, when you're actually browsing through your files, you can see everything. So let me show you what that looks like. Now, I'm on a Chrome box, which is a Chrome computer. It's gonna look a little bit different to your Windows machine or your Mac machine. But if I open up my My Drive and Google Drive, you'll see I've got all of my Google Drive files and folders here. And if I open up my shared drive, I've got all of my shared drives, files, and folders here. So it's basically exactly the same as what I can see online in my Google Drive there. And so if I open any of these and I want to, for example, keep some of these available offline so I can access them when I'm, I don't know, on a plane or traveling or whatever, I've got to stop with the plane jokes. It's going to trigger people about travel restrictions. We've got here the option to make available offline. So if I click that make available offline, it's basically going to automatically turn that folder into an offline folder, and then I'll always have access to that offline folder. And so that's how FileStream works. It's a very intelligent way of storing your files, and it basically means that everything is safely and securely stored online. You can access it from your local machine. You can choose if you want to keep it available offline, but it doesn't clog up and fill up your local machine, and you access it just like you would your My Documents. You know, when you work on a doc, you can save it, even if it's a Microsoft document, even if it's a video file or an MP3 or whatever it happens to be, you can drop it straight into Google File Stream, and then it's just gonna do its magic synchronization in the background for you. Whether or not File Stream uses a lot of bandwidth, and someone has said that they are experiencing their Mac mail go to offline mode when File Stream is synchronizing, I would say that is most likely to do with your internet bandwidth. It's very possible that you have a, you know, patchy Wi-Fi setup at home or something like that. But it's because Wi-Fi is usually not the bottleneck. If you had Wi-Fi, you'd have like full dropouts of all of your computer internet access. But what's more likely is that you've got a bottleneck of sorts on your local internet connection. Maybe it's a little bit slower than it could be. But if you're right now using Mac Mail, my strong recommendation would be to use Gmail in the browser, because you have access to the amazing search tools. Mac Mail search tends to run out of steam after a while. And also, Mac Mail is storing your emails locally on your computer. I don't know exactly how you've got it set up, but they may not actually be stored on the cloud. And so my strong recommendation for Mac or Windows users is to always, always use Google Chrome and use Gmail in the browser. It's the fastest. It's got all of the fancy features like the snooze features and the AI-based automatic composition of your emails. And of course, it's got all of the amazing plugins and add-ons. And as Google are now calling all of your work in one place. You can see here, right here, I've got my calendar, I've got my Google Keep, I've got Google Tasks if I want to use those, I've got all my other plugins like Copper CRM, our CRM system, and so literally all of your work there, as well as my chat, I've even got my chat with my team, all of your work there literally sits in one place. So if right now you're still on Mac Mail, time to get into 2020 and move over to Gmail. How can I guarantee my files won't be lost if I put them inside of Google Drive? And that's really an excellent question, because there's a fear of, if I put all my stuff in Google's ecosystem and then I delete it from my local computer, like, what's the backup? What's the guarantee that Google doesn't like just accidentally delete my data? And my honest answer is, you do need to have some form of backup, not because Google's gonna lose your data. It has happened once in 12 years, 20,000 employees across 1,500 active customers. I lost a spreadsheet. I lost a Google spreadsheet. It became corrupted and I wasn't able to access it. One incident in all of that time. It's improbable that Google's going to lose your data. What's much more probable is human error, either yourself or your staff, something going wrong, or a crypto lock or virus. In all of those cases, we recommend that you have a cloud-to-cloud backup solution. We call it a cloud-to-cloud disaster recovery solution. Our team can talk to you about some options there and our recommendation, and it is included for free as part of our concierge membership. So if you're a concierge member, you just get that by default, because we believe that's mandatory for everyone with a Google Workspace account. Great question. Cool. Okay. Dropbox is updated with Smart Sync. Oh, that is very interesting to know, Jessica. I did not know that. That is very good to know. Thank you for sharing. Can you select when Google File Stream syncs? David, I believe there's an option to rate limit the bandwidth that Google File Sync uses, File Stream uses. I don't think you can do time-based, but you can use other software to do time-based synchronization, like to limit the network port. I'm getting very geeky here, but there's software that you can use, whether you're on a Mac or a PC, which will just block the Google File Stream network port at certain times per day. If you Google around, see if you can find something. If you can't find it, you're welcome to get in touch with our team with that. Donna said, I work alone, no team. My business is just me. Been using Microsoft forever. Will Google Workspace be beneficial? Oh, that's a good question, Don. We've got a question here. If Google Workspace is useful for sole traders, and I would always say that you can get more efficiency using Google's tools, like the amazing search inside of Gmail, like using Google's documents so you never ever lose your work with your computer crashing because everything's always automatically saved online. I personally like working with Google's tools because I find them simpler and I find them easier to use. So they're the reasons why I like working with Google. I would also say that if right now you're a sole trader, hopefully your ambition is not to exchange your time for money forever. And that's going to involve at some stage in your business journey, growing a team. And when you're growing a team, that means that you're going to graduate out of launch stage, then into startup and maybe even growth stage. Now, this growth roadmap of business and our desire to help businesses grow to the magic number of 20 employees so they can graduate from growth to scale is not about just creating more money and creating larger businesses for the sake of creating them. It's actually all about empowering business owners to have more freedom in their life. When you have a business that has more than 20 employees, you can work one day a week if you want to, or sometimes even less. And that's actually the true definition of a business, which is something that can work without you. So I've got a question here. If there is an option for us to have an intranet solution inside of Google Workspace, something similar to Microsoft SharePoint. And I really love that question because we have spoken for so long about the importance of having an intranet to store your systems and processes and your how-tos for your business, so your team can actually know what on earth is going on and you can onboard and have your team working effectively together by documenting the processes in your business. Now, Google has something called Google Sites, which we've used for many years to document all of our systems and processes. We have many training videos on this. We have some up on our public YouTube channel, and we've done a seminar, a whole webinar on systemizing your business just recently where we covered some of Google Sites. So jump on into our Google group to get access to that if you're interested in that. But you'll see here inside my Google site, I have everything for our team. I mean, our team now basically build this. And so we've got forms embedded, we've got surveys, we've got, even here, if we open up different files, we've got videos embedded. Basically, we've got all kinds of stuff inside our Google site, and that's our intranet for everything business-wise. So thanks so much for sharing that question. If you're interested in learning more about an intranet, have a look at more of our videos on our YouTube channel on systemizing your business. And we have even more videos inside Genius Academy, which is our members-only area for our concierge members. Okay, last section, guys. Thank you so much for sticking with me. We're going to wrap up very soon. I want to talk quickly about how to transition your team off Dropbox if you've decided to make the switch from Dropbox over to Google Drive. Now, if right now you're still using Dropbox and you're feeling like it's a double up in a subscription, there's three or four, I think we've got, simple steps on moving your data across from Dropbox to Drive. Now, step number one is to actually complete a data audit, and that is to audit all of the files, all of the software, all of the stuff sitting inside your Dropbox. And for that, we recommend our auditing tools, of which there's one here for Mac and there's one there for Windows as well. And that audit is, in a way, kind of looking at, well, you know, what should I keep and what should I get rid of? But really, it's about looking at how can I structure my file system so it's actually logical and it's going to make sense for my staff to access it. But also, you've got to see exactly how much data you've got and how long it's going to take to move it across. Next up, we're going to set up your permissions. We're going to set up a file structure, and my recommendation is that you use the shared drives feature. And inside the shared drives feature, you can see here, for an example, I'll open up my my training folder here, and I'll let you see how I've got the permissions set up in my training folder. So the executive team managers, and that means they can basically do whatever they want with the file. Our pod leaders, who are our leadership team, can add files and they can edit files. But they can't delete anything. So they're really just kind of like contributors. You can see here, they're literally called contributors there. And I've got a little information card that's popped up here. I don't know why. Oh, let me bring it back. All right. Next up, we have Empower Team, which is our HR team, and they are content managers, which means they can add, they can move stuff around, and they can also delete files. So they're responsible for keeping this nice and tidy. And you can see here, we have the rest of the team here also with the option to contribute. That's a little odd. They probably should only have view-only access. So I'm going to switch the rest of the team to view-only access, which is the whole company there. And so there you can see we've got different levels of group-based permissions, very important. And these are all linked to everyone's Google accounts. And so our group-based permissions dictate who can access what. So someone joins our company, we add them to the sales team and the sales group, and then they automatically get access to everything that the sales team group have access to, which will be the right calendar. They get invited to the right recurring events. It just automatically comes through to their email. And then they automatically get access to the correct shared drives that they need. We've covered off how to do group-based permissions, and inside Google Shared Drives, there's also some pretty groovy file settings as well. So if I open up my shared drive settings, you can see I can choose to restrict whether or not people inside or outside the business can be shared to individual files. I can choose whether or not I want to restrict people from downloading or printing files. And so that's the kind of thing that's really useful if you've got like a franchise or if you've got a number of contractors and you want to share read-only access to something, but you're concerned that someone might rip off your data. And so you want to restrict their ability to download or make copies, or maybe you're sharing sensitive information for a limited period of time and you don't necessarily want to just openly kind of share it with them forever. So a couple of little tips there that might be useful for you guys. Finally, the last step in the process is to drag and drop your data. You can just drag and drop it all from Dropbox into Google Drive. However, that is the slow way of doing it. The fast way of doing it is through a cloud sync, cloud to cloud, and our team actually will do that for you as a service. So if you're interested in that, in doing it the easy way, have a chat to our team. It's included as part of our concierge program. And we do every day of the week, cloud to cloud migrations from Dropbox into Google Drive. And if right now you're paying for Dropbox for your team, then you may be able to save a little bit of money there. I'm gonna take final Q&A now, guys. So drop in your final questions. I'm gonna do a little bit of a wrap up here and then I'll cover off some final Q&A. But thanks so much for joining, and I will be with you guys soon. So I just want to share again our growth roadmap, and this is how we take businesses along the journey of growth and ensure that your technology strategy is nailed and dialed in at every step of the way. Now, if you're a launch business or a startup business and you may not be ready to take up one of our services like our concierge membership, well, you can watch all of the videos in our YouTube channel, and also make sure you join our free business group for business owners utilizing Google Workspace. Inside that group, we have more exclusive content, more learning, and we also have a free, yes, completely free course for users who are using Google Workspace. So if you want to get up to speed on the basics of Workspace, you do need to transfer your licenses into us. So we manage your billing for your Workspace account, but you can check out that offer inside our Google group. If you want to check that out, jump in there, guys. Now, if you're a growth business or a scale business, or even if you're a startup business and you're interested in some help and support, then we offer a free consultation with our team. They'll go through the growth roadmap with you. They'll check in on all the different types of technology that are relevant to you at your business stage. They'll make sure that you haven't missed anything in the earlier stages of business that you've been through, and they will help you to make sure that things are right. If you're interested in getting in touch with our team, here's our details, and we look forward to catching up with you soon. Let me jump in and check for any questions that have come through. I have files from 2003. I'm a digital hoarder. Yes, I am also a digital hoarder. Totally get that, Jessica. Cool. David said, I have clients accessing Dropbox. Does Google Drive require a sharee to have a Google account? Yes, David, they have to sign up for Google Drive, but they can just use a Gmail for that for free. Cloud-to-cloud backup with Concierge, but doesn't using Dropbox and Google Drive act the same way as a cloud-to-cloud backup? Okay, Don. So I think you may have confused. What I meant by cloud-to-cloud is a cloud-to-cloud migration of your data. So moving it once from Dropbox over to Google Drive, that's a cloud-to-cloud migration of data, because basically we're gonna move it out of Dropbox and then we're gonna shut it down. The cloud-to-cloud backup is the disaster recovery backup. So that's from Google Drive to a third-party safe, secure data center. So that's if you get infected by CryptoLocker, if someone deletes some stuff from your account maliciously, or for whatever reason, you need to do a full restore of your Google Drive, we use that there. So thank you so much for joining, everyone. Please make sure you join our group if you have not already. There is a link to it right here on the live. You can jump on and get in there. You get earlier access to lives that we do inside the group, a little bit more Workspace focused. So if you're already a Workspace customer, then you wanna make sure you check that out. And we'll catch you in the next one. Thanks so much for joining, and have a great evening. Cheers.